I have tried to gather some confidence and courage to do this video. It is a very, it's a very personal thing, and if I'm crying, I'm just going to warn you, I don't seek pity. I'm doing this for me, and I'm going to do this for you or other people that have this problem. It is what you make it to. But yeah, now is the time to do this video. It's so hard. Wow. I have my computer here next to me. So if I'm looking down and to my left side, that is because I'm looking at my computer. I have written down some numbers and some keywords if I lose track, you know? Hopefully not. I don't know if I'm going to start out this video as I used to, because it's not a happy video, it's not a sad video, it's just a sit down and talk to you guys and be brutally honest with you. I'm just going to say, I'm just going to say it. I have a condition, I think you can say, a diagnosis called scoliosis. And for you who don't know, which is most of the people that I talk to, that is a spine illness diagnosis. Okay, my spine in my back is formed as an S, which can sound dramatic and kind of is. So yeah, I have scoliosis, I have a back disease, illness, diagnosis, and it is affecting my life to that point that I need surgery. And I'm getting that surgery in a month from now on, less than a month, on November 5th. That's that. Okay, there are some really, really hard words on English, so don't be hard on me if I mispronounce, because I'm used to saying these words and this story overall in Danish. I haven't told it in English. I just wrote down the words and translated the words I didn't know how to pronounce this morning. And I think I'm ready, even though it's hard. And I may cry. Okay, so I'm sorry if you don't want to hear my story, and I'm sorry if this is going to be a very long video. I will try to make it short, but at the same time I really want to share as much as I can. But if you do have further questions, and if I haven't talked about it when we end this video, and if you're still here, I hope you are, please let me know down in the comments and we can chat. And please comment down below your questions, because then everyone can see them, and if they are thinking the same, you know? Maybe I'm going to sit like this, and maybe I'm going to sit like this, and that is my back, and I'm sitting like this if it hurts, and this if I realize. So that's just a note there. And you may have seen that in videos from me before. Me going up and down. And I may look out the window, because that is just easier, because I feel like I'm looking into your eyes. I know you rather want that, but maybe I'm going to look out the windows on the trees and the blue sky. We found out in when I say we, it is me and my parents. We found out in 2008, I believe. 2008 or 2009, I'm not really sure. I believe it's 2008. It's 10 years ago. Yeah, 2008. We found out by my swim teacher asking me if my back or my leg hurt because I was limping. Is that when you're not walking straight, you know? And I said no. And then she said, maybe you should see your doctor because it looks like you're hurting. So I got home, I said that to my mom, and we made an appointment with my doctor. First, he of course listened to us, and we said we were very confused because we have not noticed anything. It didn't hurt anything. I don't really remember, but I must have felt something in my back because I did have scoliosis, and we believe I have had it for a while. Scoliosis can come, can be a genetic thing. I hope it's pronounced that way, or it is just something that comes out of the blue when you're a teenager, and it often is girls, but boys do have it. I don't know what he said, but he definitely said I should take off my shirt and then I should bend over so he could see me from the front and the back, and he could see my shoulders, your shoulder blades, is that what it's called? What, mine was here and the other one was here. So your back is going like this, you know. That is one sign for scoliosis, that your back is not straight. Because he couldn't really see something when I was sitting down because my scoliosis was not that big. So he said, yeah, that is definitely scoliosis, but if you're not hurting anything, we can give you some exercises that you can take home, and you need to do them every day. I was a teenager. I was 13 years old. You don't do your exercises. You just don't, because you're a teenager and rebel inside. When we got home that day, my mom took a picture of my back because she overthinks like I do. You need to take pictures of everything. And she luckily took a picture of my back that day. And I did the exercises for a year. And then we took another picture because my back was beginning to hurt. I was beginning to have the pains in my back. We took the picture, we compared it to the other picture we took the year before. And we could definitely see a difference. And I was leaning more towards the right side than I did the year before. We compared the pictures and we called and got an appointment with my doctor, and we said we need to do something because look at these pictures, there's massive difference in a year. So he made an appointment with an orthopedic surgeon. The hospital took an x-ray of my back, and a x-ray, I have no idea. And then we could see on his computer then that it showed like around 28 degrees. It is so long time ago, but it was around there. He didn't expect my scoliosis to get worse, even though we said how much it had gotten worse the past year. We showed him the pictures, but he just said it won't get worse because you have had your period for 2 to 3 years at this point, so you're fully grown. I don't like that doctor, by the way. I don't like him, so if I make faces of him, that's why. So he told me to eat well, don't smoke, and work out, and then everything will be fine. No. All doctors kind of say that. They need to say that because then you are healthy. But I'm not. I have scoliosis. My back hurts so bad. But he just said, oh, you will get another appointment next year. So a checkup update, you know, how it's going, and we can talk there. It didn't get worse, I believe, in the next year, because I was just in high school and not that much pressure and stuff like that. So in 2010, summer 2010, I went to boarding school, and boarding school was some of my worst and best years of my life because I made friends for life. I did, but they were so painful for me. So in a good mindset, I went to boarding school. One boarding school year is one full year, you know, from August to June. And in that year, I had a lot of sick days. I was in pain and it was just awful. Yeah, we were also supposed to walk every single morning, because we had to, so we did. And it was not a long walk, so it was okay for me, but it was hard. It was really, really hard. And I'm not a morning person. I never will be. And then I had my back pains at the same time, and we were supposed to walk like 2 to 3 km. So after the first year of boarding school and before the second year of boarding school, I went to a checkup with the doctor, and it was bad. It was very, very bad. And he was kind of mind blown and speechless. He didn't know what to say because he was in the mindset that I was fully grown and nothing was supposed to change, and I got a new x-ray and stuff like that. And as I said before, I was supposed to be 28 degrees, but I'm now about 35 degrees. And I should say that when you have scoliosis, it is normal to increase your degrees with one each year. And this has been like in a year, not even a year. It is so... I can't remember what I have wrote, so I'm so sorry. 35, or he said about 40 degrees. About 40. We will come to that in later. So he didn't do anything because you talk surgery when you are 40, but I didn't have enough pain. My scoliosis wasn't bad enough to the point we can talk about a surgery. So he didn't do anything. But he said the words again: eat well, don't smoke, and work out. So I did. I couldn't do anything else. So we couldn't do anything because we couldn't talk to him. He didn't listen to us. It was not very fun. It really wasn't. So the second year of boarding school was different because I didn't have badminton. I had some outdoor activity live classes, and I used my more creative side and stuff like that. I still did the walks every morning, but I got an exception on Tuesdays because my mentor thingy, contact teacher, roughly translated from Danish, she has an education in tendons treatment, I believe. I'm not sure. I don't know the fancy words in English. So she did a massage with oil, focused on my tendons, which helped so much. I wasn't in that much pain. So my second year of boarding school was definitely better than the first one. After boarding school ended, we needed to do a checkup before I went to college. My scoliosis wasn't worse, I believe. Maybe I'm mixing up some of the checkups, I don't know. But it wasn't worse. I know the in-between updates for the boarding school was the worst part. So it wasn't worse, so he just said the magic words again. Eat well, don't smoke, and work out. I hate that sentence so much. I have never been so angry at a person saying those words that I am with him. I hate those words because you can't always do that when you have a scoliosis, because it is so tiring. You get exhausted on another level than a normal person would. It's just hard, okay? It's just hard. It is 2012. I ended my last year of boarding school and I was going to begin college. I have no idea where I'm going to begin. It was so awful. I didn't like it at all. It was rough because the transportation time for me with a bus ride and stuff and waiting on the bus back and forth was more, maybe 3 hours, maybe more each day, 5 days a week. I was so tired when I came home from school that I slept for at least 2 hours. I had some, I didn't really have any activities after school. I didn't really see my friends after school, even though I really wanted to, but I was just too tired. So we didn't, we saw each other on the weekend. Sometimes we went out a lot drinking, you know, because that is very normal in Denmark when you are 17, 18, 19. To go out a lot. The first year of college, I got my driver's license and I was so happy because that meant I was not forced to take the bus. I could drive my mom's car, so I borrowed my mom's car for like a year or something before I got my own place, which was my second year of college. I moved out closer to my college and therefore I had my bike, so I could ride my bike to school. It was like 5 to 10 minutes away. It was awesome. It was easier to see my friends from boarding school and in college, so it was just so amazing. So throughout college I was missing that tendons treatment thingy I got in high school, no, in boarding school, so much, because that was so expensive. I got a really, really nice discount on boarding school that my mom paid. And I got it a few times when I came home from another person, but it was just too expensive to do every week. If I was lucky, I did it. I got a treatment like every 2 months or so. So I really missed that, but I did work out with my physiotherapist and I discovered a special form for gymnastic for your back called Campana. And I went to that when I lived home and when I lived by myself, because I saw a big difference in my back pains. When I worked out at the physiotherapist 2 times a week and then 1 time a week the other gymnastic thing. This is a hard video to get through because my camera and SD card and stuff won't cooperate that much. But it was time for a new update at the surgeon. nothing have happened because I did my workouts, and it was like my scoliosis was set on pause or something. So nothing happened, but that sentence came again. Eat well, don't smoke, and work out, and everything will be fine. Every time I saw him, I got more and more mad. This was also the checkup on my back that I pointed out on his screen. You say I'm 40 degrees crooked, but on your screen it says 35. And I have always learned through other people's experience and what we knew at that point, that 5 degrees is a lot in a difference. So we were just like, why do you keep saying 40 and not 35 when the screen says 35? And he was just like, oh, it's not a correct measurement. It's just around 35, around 40. It's not an exact measurement. We got so mad, and I didn't understand anything, but because he is a surgeon and he is highly educated and authority and stuff like that, we were just like, okay, then it must be true, then it must be okay. Maybe a little naive, but we didn't know what to do. We knew a bunch of people, and we said that to them, and they didn't understand why he said those things. Then I finished college. I went to Germany. I didn't have my physiotherapist there. We walked a lot down there, and I took my bike to work, and that was 4 kilometers. That way I worked out, and because I didn't have the pressure from the school and stuff, my back was fine. I still had the pains, but it wasn't as bad as when I was in school. I went to Germany in 2015, and then in 2016 I came back to Denmark and I started uni. So I went to see him again, and it was the same thing with the surgeon. Nothing new, you're still the same degrees, and you just eat well, don't smoke, and you work out, and everything will be fine. So I started uni, and a quick conclusion on uni. I only have 3 words to describe it. It was hell. I think that was the perfect description, because I didn't make any friends. The friends I thought I had dumped me. So that is just personal, socially. I got one friend, but I don't see her now. After I got extreme anxiety, depression, stress. I'm not diagnosed or anything. I did get diagnosed with presentation anxiety, stuff like that, and I have had that since middle school or something. I have never liked exams, but that's just another topic. But that those three factors, four actually, they describe my mental health state very nicely, and that didn't help that my back pain was extremely, extremely intense. And they were okay around the time that I got that checkup thingy from my surgeon. But they just got worse and worse and worse. So bad that I contacted my own doctor, which is a different doctor than the one in the beginning of my situation, illness, diagnose. scoliosis history, I don't know, story. I called him and got an appointment, and I got this very big painkillers. Those painkillers were bigger with the milligrams than the regular ones, so they would work better. But I took those for like 1.5 years and they didn't help at all. That's just great. I'm not on those anymore because, again, they don't work. I have too much pain for painkillers to work, which says a lot, because before uni I could just take a few painkillers and then I'm good to go. Nothing there. It could take most of the pain, not everything, but half of the pain. Now it can take like the teeny tiny top of the painkillers rate, you know. When I said, oh, I feel so sorry for myself, I have so much pain, and then my anxiety and depression all in one bundle, that was a mess. It was hell. As I said in the beginning, it was just awful. And I feel so sorry for my boyfriend because I got together with my boyfriend just before I went to Germany. So he had been in this rumble for over 3 years now. I feel so sorry for him because I have not been the best girlfriend because of my mood swings. But he's still here and he have no desire to leave. Even though I don't really understand it at some point, sometimes, I don't know. I'm trying to be better, and he has said after uni, everything got better. I was happier. I was not so depressed, and my anxiety was slow going away. My stress factor was dropping. Everything was dropping, and I'm just happier. I'm happier now that I'm not in school, and my mindset right now, it can change, but my mindset right now is never ever am I going to school again. Because as I just said, I got anxiety, depression, stress, everything, and my presentation and anxiety on top. No way. And my back does not like school. So that is a good excuse for me not going to school again. But when I say that to some people, they don't understand. Why don't you want to study more? And you need a higher education and blah, 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 blah. And Denmark is like that. The higher education you can get, the better. You can make more money. I don't care. I want to be happy. And no more school makes me happy. When it was time for me to get my checkup, I changed hospital because no way I was going back to that jerk. And I'm calling him a jerk because he was a jerk to me. And as you can tell from this story, I didn't like him, so I wanted a new pair of eyes to look at my x-rays and tell me something different than eat well, don't smoke, and work out. I want another sentence. So I changed. I got a recommendation to another hospital that I chose. It was a few hours away from now where I live, but if I can see the best surgeon in Denmark, recommendations from other people in my spot, I'm going to drive 2 hours to see him. And he said, the x-ray shows that you have increased 5 degrees on your scoliosis, which is a lot in 1.5 years, and on top of that, your spine is beginning to rotate around itself, and that is the top half of your spine between your shoulder blades. So no wonder I was in hell with my back pains, and no wonder that I felt horrible. So I was so relieved. I was kind of sad. I felt pity about myself, and I was so happy because he said something else than, oh, there's nothing to see. You know what I mean. So he said, I would recommend you to get a surgery. again, all the emotion was there, they still are. Okay, don't cry. I had waited maybe 4 to 6 years for someone. For someone to say, I want to do something. Okay, why? Okay, now that my camera is on 3%, I'm going to cry. Okay. So he set a date, and I did move the date because my cousin is getting married next weekend, and my surgery was before that, so I moved it, and it is now on November 5th, as I said in the beginning, and as you can tell, this is happy tears. I'm not sad about it, I'm scared as AF. And all that, but I'm really, really looking forward to not feel bad and not hate my back. I'm excited for my new back because there's a big possibility that I don't have as much pain in my back. My flexibility is going to be gone in my back. I don't know what they're called in English, but I get some to make it stiff. So that is exciting. And my boyfriend have said to his boss that he is going to take a vacation, or he's not coming to work that week, that I am going to be in the hospital because I am for a week after post-surgery. And that also means that I am pre-filming most of November, and this is possibly going up on that date. So I'm going to make a vlog and updates and all that jazz. And I'm going to go now because there's 1%. So if you have any comments or questions or anything, leave them down below. And until I will see you again, please take care. I love you guys. Yeah.